we are making cinnamon buns. This is a family treat because, like, my dad says these cinnamon buns taste like heaven. It's his favorite dessert that I make, and it takes a lot of time, so it's a really long recipe. So for the baking equipment, we'll need measuring cups and spoons, which is great. For mixing bowls, which we just have three mixing bowls right here. One, two, three. But during the video, we will wash one of them. So, and we will also need an electric hand mixer, but it says fitted with a dough hook, but it's fine when it's just, we don't have a dough hook. You don't really have to use a dough hook. It just says to. And then you need a whisk, which is right here. Oh, I forgot to show you the mixer. It's right here. A 9 by 13 inch baking pan, which is right here. Parchment paper, which is right here. A rolling pin, which is right here. A rubber spatula, right here. A knife, right here. Oven safe gloves. Make the dough in a mixing bowl or the bowl of a stand mixer. Whisk together the milk, water, and active dry yeast. Set aside for 10 minutes or until foamy. So first, get the ingredients in the mixing bowl. Stuff because I'm starting to mix and put it on the counter or somewhere. So, now we are going to read the ingredients. So it says warm milk. So the milk is in our fridge. So let's get that out. And it's cold milk. So I'm going to get a half of a cup and get a bowl out and pour it in a little bowl and put it in the microwave for a little bit. So I'm getting half of a cup and a bowl. Because it says warm milk, a half cup of warm milk. So pour that half cup. bowl or the bowl of a stand mixer with together the milk, water, and active dry yeast. The warm water, warm milk, and active dry yeast. And just whisk it for a little bit until it's all combined. And it says set aside for 10 minutes or until foaming. So I'm going to set it aside right here. And we have a timer on our microwave, so I'm just going to turn on the timer and put it for 10 minutes until that timer goes off and like a beep sound. So that's when we can do something like that. So next, in another mixing bowl, stir together the flour, granulated white sugar, and salt. So together the flour, granulated white sugar, and salt. So we just need to mix it together. Spoon. So now we can pour the active dry yeast mixture into here. And then stir till combined using a wooden spoon. So now that we got the dough all mixed, it should look like this. Like that. So next, using an electric hand mixer, mix at low speed and add the butter slowly. Increase the speed to medium, then add the egg and mix until combined. About 1 minute. So I'm going to get the butter and get my knife right here. And we will need a half stick of unsalted butter, softened, so about 4 tablespoons of butter and salt. So I'm gonna cut it in half. Okay. Now we already got the butter out because we looked over the recipe and it said soften. So we just got the butter. So we're going to unwrap the butter. Okay. Now I'm going to put the butter on the paper, the wrapper that you unwrap the butter, and cut into small pieces because it said to put it in slowly. So cut in small pieces. So next we would have to plug in the electric mixer. So just to add it in slowly, the butter, add it, the butter in slowly. I'm going to add 2 pieces of butter, like 2 slices of butter that I cut at a time. Then I'm going to mix it and do that again after I'm done. I'm going to keep mixing. Mix it again. in about 1 minute. So we are going to transfer the dough to a flour service and knead for 8 minutes. Add more flour if dough is too wet. So we need to clear this table and put parchment paper on it. So just clean this table up. So now I'm going to put some of the parchment paper on the table. people don't just don't follow my rule how I tear plastic wrap. So, yeah. And after we do laundry or something, like dry clothes in our dryer, which is in our laundry room, we don't turn the dryer on. We don't. That would not be good. So we just put it in the dryer because it's a warm place. Because we just dried some of our clothes. So I'm going to put it in our dryer. Packed dark brown sugar. I said in the last video, I think I said it, you always want to pack the sugar, the brown sugar. Always want to pack it. I think that's pretty packed. Okay, so next, a fourth cup of granulated white sugar. So get the white sugar over here. Tablespoons of ground cinnamon. Okay, let's get the cinnamon, which is right here. So I think I'm gonna unscrew this. Two of these. A 4 teaspoon of kosher salt. Get the kosher salt. One in there. Then, yeah, remember in the directions it said to use an electric pan mixer and another mixing bowl, cream together the butter, brown sugar, granulated white sugar, cinnamon, and salt on high speed for 3 minutes or until fully combined. So, I'm going to get my electric mixer right here and plug it in since we have a timer on our microwave. What the filling should look like. Now that we made the filling, it's time to get our dough out of our warm place. So we had to wait for 1.5 hours, so that's it took a long time. So now we need to take cover the plastic wrap. You see how that dough rises? That's what we wanted. That's what we wanted. See how that dough rises? Lightly flour a clean work surface and a rolling pin. Remove the dough from the bowl and place it on the flour surface. Roll out the dough to a half of an inch thickness. So I'm going to, since I kind of struggle with getting the parchment paper off, I'm going to use scissors this time. another layer of this parchment paper. So, okay, so now I'm going to put some, lightly cover this parchment paper with flour. Into a shape of a log and cut into 8 equal rolls. So now I got the spatula from over there, so I'm going to put the filling. So the secret to cinnamon buns for rolling it is to roll it tight and roll it away from you. log here. So next, get a knife and cut it into 8 equal pieces. A good time to clean up, so I'm going to clean up. So the dough has been rising for 15 minutes. Now we're going to let it rise for another 15 minutes. We're going to preheat our oven to 375. So, we're going to use our microwave timer and set for 15 minutes. And wait till that goes off. different mixing bowl while those buns are baking. Doing 2 tablespoons of unsalted butter. So you use a knife to cut the butter. Supposed to put the frosting on right away after you get out of the really good, and I think it would taste really good, so I'm going to, and it really also really smells good, so I'm going to try it. That is yummy. You have to try it.